Laudato Jesus Christus, praise be Jesus. Welcome to the live broadcast of the Holy Father Pope Francis's Wednesday General Audience for the 28th of August 2024. We're coming to you live from St. Peter's Square here in the Vatican. My name is Father Paul Samasumo. On behalf of Vatican News Media, I'd like to welcome all of you joining us for Pope Francis's General Audience. Our partner television and radio broadcasters of Luminous Radio India, Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, Radio Maria England, Catholic Faith Network in America, Catholic TV, Shalom World Television, Salt and Light TV, Atmadashan TV, EWTN TV. To those of you following us on our Vatican News website stream, or our many Vatican News social media channels, Facebook, our Facebook stream, YouTube, and also our shortwave radio frequencies, and also not forgetting the Catholic National and Diocesan Religious Stations broadcasting this event. Welcome, so glad you could join us for Pope Francis's General Weekly Audience. Right now in the square, Pope Francis has just concluded his round, going round the square, greeting pilgrims in his Pope Mobile. And for our listeners, the Holy Father, as usual, as he always does, had with him in the Pope Mobile some children that he took round with him for the joy ride. The Pope is now making his way to the stage where he will conduct the general audience for today. And looking ahead in the coming week, Pope Francis is making a historical visit to Asia and Oceania. The Holy Father will be visiting four countries starting next week on Monday, the 2nd of September to the 13th of September. These are Indonesia, Timor-Est, Singapore, and Papua New Guinea. We could say at 87 years old, this will be Pope Francis's longest apostolic journey, both in terms of distance to be covered as well as the days away from the Vatican. It will be the 45th trip of Pope Francis in his pontificate, and according to the Vatican official organizing the trip, the Pope is expected on these visits to encourage interreligious dialogue, ethnic harmony, care for creation, and perhaps shed light on migrants and migration. Pope Francis will first visit Indonesia, and as you know, Indonesia is the largest Muslim population of any country in the world. Indonesia is home to roughly 242 million Muslims and 29 million Christians, of whom 8.5 million are Catholics. Then the Holy Father will move to Papua New Guinea and also Timor-Est and Singapore. Right now, Pope Francis greeting some of the people that will be reading the summaries and making the translations in the various languages. Most of them are employees of Vatican Media, Vatican Radio. I was just talking about the Holy Father's up-and-coming visit to four countries: Indonesia, Papua New Guinea, Timor-Est, and Singapore. And back to the square, the St. Peter's Square. Last week, catechesis, Pope Francis continues his catechesis series on the Holy Spirit, and he reflected on Jesus' baptism and the Holy Spirit's anointing of the Son of God. Today, the Holy Father Pope Francis's catechesis will be based on the scripture reading taken from Psalm 107. And a loud applause to Pope Francis as he makes his way to the seat to begin the audience of today. He will introduce by the sign of the Holy Cross. Let us now compose ourselves to begin this general audience.
La pace sia con voi.
Peace be with you. And now we prepare to hear the proclamation of the readings from today's various languages. And it's from Psalm 107.
Alcuni vagavano nel deserto su strade perdute, senza trovare una città dove abitare. Erano affamati e assetati. Veniva meno la loro vita. Nell'angustia gridarono al Signore, ed Egli li liberò dalle loro angosce. Parola di Dio.
Du livre des psaumes. Rendez grâce au Seigneur car il est bon. Éternel est son amour. Certains erraient dans le désert sur des chemins perdus, sans trouver de ville où s'établir. Ils souffraient la faim et la soif, ils sentaient leur âme défaillir. Dans leur angoisse, ils ont crié vers le Seigneur, et lui les a tirés de la détresse. Parole du Seigneur.
A reading from the book of Psalms. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his great love is without end. Some wandered in the desert, in the wilderness, finding no way to a city they could dwell in. Hungry they were and thirsty. Their soul was fainting within them. Then they cried to the Lord in their need, and he rescued them from their distress. The word of the Lord.
Lesung aus dem Buch der Psalmen. Dankt dem Herrn, denn er ist gut, denn seine Huld währt ewig. Sie, die umherirrten in der Wüste, im Ödland und den Weg zur bewohnten Stadt nicht fanden, die Hunger litten und Durst, denen das Leben dahinschwand. Sie schrien zum Herrn in ihrer Bedrängnis und er entriss sie ihren Nöten. Wort des lebendigen Gottes.
Lectura del libro de los Salmos. Den gracias al Señor porque es bueno, porque es eterno su amor. Los que iban errantes por el desierto solitario, sin hallar el camino hacia un lugar habitable, estaban hambrientos, tenían sed y ya les faltaba el aliento. Pero en la angustia invocaron al Señor y Él los libró de sus tribulaciones. Palabra de Dios.
Leitura do livro dos Salmos. Dai graças ao Senhor, porque Ele é bom, porque é eterna a sua misericórdia. Uns vagueavam no deserto, extraviados, sem encontrar o caminho da cidade. Sofriam fome e também sofriam sede. E sua vida ia aos poucos definhando. Mas gritaram ao Senhor na aflição, e Ele os libertou daquela angústia. Palavra do Senhor.
قراءة من سفر المزامير. أحمد الرب لأنه صالح، لأن للأبد رحمته. تاهوا في برية مقفرة ولم يجدوا سبيلا إلى مدينة مأهولة. جاع عطاش تخور نفوسهم فيهم فصرخوا إلى الرب في ضيقهم فأنقذهم من شدائدهم. كلام الرب.
Czytanie z Księgi Psalmów. Wysławiajcie Pana, bo jest dobry, bo Jego łaska na wieki. Błądzili na pustyni, na odludziu. Do miasta zamieszkałego nie znaleźli drogi. Cierpieli głód i pragnienie i ustawało w nich życie. W swoim ucisku wołali do Pana, a On ich uwolnił od trwogi. Oto Słowo Boże.
So that brings to an end the readings of today in the various languages. And now we expect the Holy Father to give the catechesis, the teaching of today's general audience. We now prepare ourselves to listen to the Holy Father.
Cari fratelli e sorelle.
Dear brothers and sisters, good morning. Today, postponing the usual catechesis, I would like to pause for a while with you to reflect about people who, even at this moment, are crossing seas and deserts to reach a land where they can live in peace and safety. Sea and desert. And desert. These two words often come to me in many testimonies I receive, both on the part of migrants and persons who come to their aid. When I say sea, in the context of migration, I also mean ocean, lake, river, and all the insidious bodies of water that so many brothers and sisters all over the world are forced to cross in order to reach their destination. A desert is not only composed of sand and dunes or rocks, but there are also those inaccessible and dangerous territories, such as territories, jungles, steppes, where migrants walk alone, left to their own devices. Today's migrants and desert. Today's migratory routes are often marked by crossings of sea and deserts, which for many, too many people, are deadly. That's why for this reason today I decided to stop and speak about this drama, about this pain. Some of these routes we know well because they are often in the spotlight. Others, the majority of them, are little known, but no less traveled. I have spoken about the Mediterranean many times because I am the Bishop of Rome and because it is emblematic. The Mare Nostrum, a place of communication between peoples and civilizations, has become our Mare Nostrum has become a cemetery. And the tragedy is that many, the majority of these deaths, could have been prevented. It must be said clearly, there are those who work systematically and with every means possible to repel migrants. And this, when done with awareness and responsibility, is a grave sin. Let us not forget what the Bible tells us. You shall not wrong the stranger or oppress him. the orphan, the widow, and the stranger are the quintessential poor whom God always defends and asks to be defended. Some deserts, too, unfortunately, are becoming cemeteries of migrants. And even here, it is not always a question of natural deaths. No. At times, they've been taken to the desert and abandoned there. We all know the photo of a man and woman and the family who died in the desert of thirst and hunger. In a world of satellites and drones, there are migrant men, women, and children that no one must see or wishes to see. Only God sees them and hears their cry. And this is a cruel action of our civilization. Indeed, the seas and deserts are biblical places loaded with symbolic value. They are very important scenes in the history of Exodus, the great migration of the people of God, led by God through Moses from Egypt to the Promised Land. These places witness to the drama of people fleeing oppression and slavery. They are places of suffering, fear, and desperation, but at the same time, they are places of passage for liberation and redemption to reach freedom. They are also fulfillment of God's promise. There is a psalm which says to the Lord, "The way through the sea, the path through the great waters." And another says, "He led his people through the wilderness, for he is steadfast and endures forever." These holy words tell us that to accompany the people on their journey to freedom, God himself crosses the sea and the desert. He does not remain at a distance. No, he shares in the migrants' drama. He is there with them. He suffers with them. He weeps and hopes with them, with the migrants. It will do us good today, knowing that the Lord is with the migrants in the sea in the Mediterranean. The Lord is with them. He is not with those that repel them back. Brothers and sisters, we can all agree on one thing. Migrants should not be in the sea and in those lethal deserts. But they are there, unfortunately. But it is not through restrictive laws. It is not with the militarization of borders. It is not by rejection that we will obtain this result. Instead, we'll obtain it by extending safe and legal access routes for migrants, providing refuge for those fleeing from war, violence, persecution, and various disasters. We will obtain it by promoting in every way a global governance of migration based on justice, fraternity, and solidarity, and by joining forces to combat human trafficking, to stop the criminal traffickers who mercilessly exploit the misery of others. Brothers and sisters, think about the many tragedies of the migrants, how many die in the Mediterranean. Think of Lampedusa, Crotone. How many so sad and terrible. I wish to conclude by acknowledging and praising the commitment of the many good Samaritans and those who did their utmost to rescue and serve the injured and abandoned migrants on the routes of the desperate hopes in the first, in the five continents. These courageous men and women are a sign of a humanity that does not allow itself to be contaminated by the malign culture of indifference and rejection. That culture that kills migrants with indifference and a throwaway culture. Those who cannot stay with them on the front lines, I think of the many good Samaritans that are in the on the front line, who are in the on the working on the Mediterranean, and many other associations. There are many ways to make a contribution. First and foremost, prayer. Sometimes I would like to ask you, do you pray for migrants, for those that come? Do we pray for them running away, coming to our lands to save their lives, and you want to send them away? Dear brothers and sisters, let us join our hearts and forces so that the seas and deserts do not become cemeteries, but space where God may open up roads to freedom and fraternity. Pope Francis, they are concluding his catechesis, his teaching today. Very well received by the people here. Pope Francis actually putting aside the series of catechesis he has been doing to return to the difficult topic of migration that he has titled Sea and Desert. We're now going to start listening to various summaries of the catechesis in the various languages.
Et pour votre ministère de successeur de Pierre. À la fin de cette audience, nous chanterons le Notre Père en latin. Puis le Saint-Père impartira la bénédiction apostolique. Il l'accorde spécialement aux enfants, aux personnes âgées, aux malades et aux personnes qui sont dans l'épreuve. Il bénira également les chapelets et les autres objets de dévotion que vous avez apporté à cette intention. Voici le résumé de la catéchèse que vient d'exposer Sa Sainteté le Pape François. Chers frères et sœurs, laissant pour aujourd'hui la catéchèse habituelle, je voudrais penser avec vous aux personnes qui traversent en ce moment mers et déserts de toutes sortes pour rejoindre une terre où vivre en paix et en sécurité. En tant qu'évêque de Rome, j'ai souvent parlé de la tragédie de la Méditerranée devenue un cimetière. La mer, comme le désert, sont aussi des lieux bibliques chargés de symbolisme, en particulier au moment de l'exode du peuple de Dieu vers la terre promise. Je le répète, le passage des migrants devrait être protégé et fondé sur la justice, la fraternité et la solidarité, afin d'empêcher la traite des êtres humains. Mais je n'oublie pas l'engagement de tant de bons samaritains qui se prodiguent pour les secourir. À présent, Sa Sainteté va saluer en italien les francophones.
Saluto cordialmente i pellegrini di lingua francese, particolare il gruppo del Senegal. Guidato dal Vescovo Monsignor Paul Abel Mamba. E quello del Burkina Faso. Preghiamo Sant'Agostino, che oggi celebriamo, perché i mari e i deserti diventino spazi in cui Dio possa aprire strade di libertà e fratellanza. Dio vi benedica.
En s'adressant aux francophones,
I cordially greet the French-speaking pilgrims, in particular the group of pilgrims from Burkina Faso and the group of faithful from Senegal, led by His Excellency Bishop Paul Abel Mamba. Let us pray to Saint Augustine, whom we celebrate today, that the seas and deserts may become spaces where God can open up paths of freedom and brotherhood. God bless you all.
Most Holy Father, the English-speaking pilgrims and visitors wish to express to you their sentiments of deep respect and esteem, and to assure you of their prayers for your ministry as the successor of Saint Peter. The following is a summary of the Holy Father's catechesis at the beginning of the audience. Dear brothers and sisters, in this audience, I invite you to join me in thinking of and praying for our brothers and sisters who even now seek to escape war, violence, persecution, and disasters, and to set out in search of a land where they can live in peace and security. Many of these migrants, including young children, suffer greatly and die along the way. Most of these tragedies could be prevented. The teaching of Scripture is clear. God especially loves His children who are poor and in need, and we are called to help and defend them. Rather than more restrictive laws and the militarization of borders, what is needed is an expansion of secure and regular means of access, and a global governance of migrations based on justice, fraternity, and solidarity. May we not turn a blind eye to these brothers and sisters. May we support those who seek to assist them. And above all, may we pray fervently for just solutions to this grave humanitarian crisis. The Holy Father will now greet us in Italian.
Do un cordiale benvenuto ai pellegrini di lingua inglese presenti all'odierna udienza, specialmente al gruppo di studenti e insegnanti provenienti dalla Norvegia. Su tutti voi e sulle vostre famiglie invoco la gioia e la pace del Signore nostro Gesù Cristo. Dio vi benedica.
I extend a warm welcome to the English-speaking pilgrims taking part in today's audience, especially the group of students and teachers from Norway. Upon all of you and your families, I invoke the joy and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ. May God bless you.
Heiliger Vater, die Gläubigen deutscher Sprache möchten Ihnen ihre herzliche Zuneigung und aufrichtige Verbundenheit bekunden und versichern Sie zugleich Ihres Gebetes in allen Anliegen Ihres universalen apostolischen Dienstes. Zum Schluss dieser Audienz singen wir gemeinsam das Vaterunser in lateinischer Sprache. Danach wird der Heilige Vater den apostolischen Segen erteilen. Gern schließt er darin Ihre Angehörigen ein, besonders die Kinder, die älteren Menschen und die Leidenden. Er segnet auch die Rosenkränze und die übrigen Andachtsgegenstände, die Sie dafür mitgebracht haben. Es folgt nun eine Zusammenfassung der Katechese des Heiligen Vaters in deutscher Sprache. Liebe Brüder und Schwestern, heute unterbrechen wir unsere Katechesenreihe, um an die vielen Migranten und Flüchtlinge zu erinnern, die vor Gewalt, Hunger, Krieg und Katastrophen fliehen. Ihr Weg auf der Suche nach Frieden und Sicherheit ist oft weit und gefährlich. sie durchqueren Meere und Wüsten, die leider vielfach zu Friedhöfen geworden sind. Auch in der Heiligen Schrift erscheinen Meere und Wüsten als Orte des Leids, der Angst und der Verzweiflung, zugleich aber auch als Orte des Übergangs in die Freiheit und der Gotteserfahrung. Stets wird deutlich, Gott ist mit seinem Volk unterwegs, er leidet und hofft mit ihm. Und so dürfen auch wir die Not der Flüchtlinge und Migranten nicht gleichgültig mit ansehen. Alle sind wir aufgerufen, uns nach unseren jeweiligen Möglichkeiten für sie einzusetzen und ihnen zu helfen. Es folgt nun der Heilige Vater richtet nun einen kurzen Gruß auf Italienisch an die deutschsprachigen Gläubigen.
Cari fratelli e sorelle di lingua tedesca, oggi celebriamo la memoria di Sant'Agostino. Lui, dopo lungo tempo e cammino interiore di ricerca, si è reso conto di quanto Dio, il nostro Creatore, ci ami e che i nostri cuori inquieti alla fine trovano riposo e pace solo in Lui. Auguro anche a voi questa esperienza della pace di Dio che supera ogni intelligenza.
Liebe Brüder und Schwestern,
dear German-speaking brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the feast of St. Augustine. He recognized, after a long internal journey of searching, how much God our Creator loves us and that our restless hearts ultimately only find rest and peace in Him. I also wish you this experience of God's peace, which transcends all understanding.
Santo Padre, los visitantes y peregrinos de lengua española que participan en esta audiencia desean manifestarle cordialmente sus sentimientos de filial afecto que acompañan con fervientes oraciones por sus intenciones de pastor de toda la Iglesia. Al final de este encuentro se cantará el Padre Nuestro en latín. Después, su santidad impartirá a todos los presentes la bendición apostólica que extiende complacido a sus familiares, especialmente a los niños y a los ancianos, a los enfermos y a cuantos sufren. Bendice también los rosarios y objetos de devoción que los peregrinos llevan consigo.
And now Pope Francis himself will give the summary in Spanish of his own catechism.
Queridos hermanos y hermanas, hoy he querido hacer un paréntesis en nuestro ciclo de catequesis habitual para que podamos reflexionar sobre la realidad de tantas personas que tienen que dejar su tierra buscando un lugar donde poder vivir en paz y con mayor seguridad. En los testimonios de migrantes que he escuchado se repiten con frecuencia la palabra mar y desierto. Lamentablemente, los mares y los desiertos de las rutas migratorias son lugares donde mueren muchas personas y por eso, como dije en otras ocasiones, se han convertido en cementerios. También en la Biblia, el mar y el desierto son lugares de sufrimiento, de miedo, de desesperación, pero al mismo tiempo son pasajes que el pueblo debe atravesar para alcanzar la libertad y el cumplimiento de las promesas de Dios. Por eso, unamos nuestras fuerzas para que estos lugares sean de paso, sean siempre de paso para los migrantes. Es decir, que sean vías de acceso seguras, donde se combata la trata de personas y se construya un futuro de esperanza para toda la humanidad. Saludo cordialmente los peregrinos.
I cordially greet the Spanish-speaking pilgrims.
Pidamos al Señor.
Let us pray to the Lord for so many people who are forced to leave their homes in search of a future, and for those who receive and accompany them, thus restoring hope and opening new paths of freedom and fraternity for them. May Jesus bless you, and may the Holy Virgin, Consolation of Migrants, watch over you. Thank you very much. Pope Francis greeting the Spanish-speaking pilgrims here in St. Peter's Square.
Santo Padre, os fiéis de língua portuguesa desejam testemunhar-lhe filial afeto e sincera fidelidade e rezam por todas as intenções do seu Ministério Apostólico Universal. No final desta audiência, cantaremos a oração do Pai Nosso em latim. Depois, o Santo Padre concederá a bênção apostólica, com um pensamento especial às crianças, aos idosos e aos doentes. Abençoará também os terços e demais objetos de devoção que cada um tiver consigo. Leio agora um resumo da catequese que o Santo Padre acaba de pronunciar. Nesta catequese, voltamos o nosso pensamento para as pessoas que também, no momento presente, atravessam mares e desertos para chegar em alguma terra onde possam viver em paz e segurança. Mar e deserto são palavras muito presentes nos testemunhos, sejam dos migrantes, sejam das pessoas que o socorrem. As rotas migratórias atuais são marcadas por longas travessias de mares e desertos, que para muitas pessoas tornam-se mortais. Podemos estar todos de acordo que os migrantes de hoje não deveriam ser forçados a estas travessias, onde tantas vezes encontram a morte. É louvável o trabalho de tantos samaritanos que se empenham por socorrer e salvar os migrantes nos 5 continentes, fazendo com que mar e deserto não sejam cemitérios, mas espaços onde Deus abre caminhos de liberdade e de fraternidade. Agora, o Santo Padre saúda em italiano os fiéis de língua portuguesa.
Saluto cordialmente i fedeli di lingua portoghese, in modo speciale quelli venuti dal Portogallo e i pellegrini delle parrocchie Cristo Bon Pastor e Nossa Signora da Paz di Porto Alegre. Aiutiamo in ogni modo possibile i migranti di oggi, anche col sostegno della nostra preghiera. Dio vi benedica.
Eis a tradução das suas palavras. Saúdo cordialmente.
I cordially greet the Portuguese speaking faithful, especially those from Portugal and the pilgrims from the parishes of Christ the Good Shepherd and Our Lady of Peace in Porto Alegre. Let us help today migrants in every possible way, also with the support of our prayers. God bless you.
Deus vos abençoe.
أيها الأب الأقدس، يسر المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية الحاضرين هنا أن يعبروا لكم عن مشاعر الاحترام والتقدير وشكرهم البنوي ويرفقونها بصلواتهم الدائمة إلى الله من أجل قداستكم وخدمتكم كخليفة القديس بطرس. في نهاية هذه المقابلة سنرتل معا صلاة الأبانا باللغة اللاتينية، ثم سيمنح الأب الأقدس جميع الحاضرين البركة الرسولية ويشمل بها جميع أحبائكم وخاصة الأطفال والمتزوجين حديثاً والمسنين والمرضى والمتألمين بآلام شديدة وسيبارك كذلك المسابح والأشياء التقوية التي يحملها معه كل واحد منكم. إليكم ملخص التعليم المسيحي لقداسة البابا فرانسيس. تكلم قداسة البابا اليوم على الأشخاص الذين يعبرون البحار والصحاري للوصول إلى أرض يمكنهم العيش فيها بسلام وأمان، وقال: البحر هو البحر، وكل مكان مائي خطر يضطر الكثيرون في كل أنحاء العالم إلى عبوره للوصول إلى وجهتهم. والصحراء ليست فقط الصحراء، بل هي أيضا كل المناطق الخطرة مثل الغابات والأدغال والسهوب، حيث يسير المهاجرون بمفردهم متروكين وحدهم للموت. وقال قداسته: هناك من يعمل بشكل منهجي وبكل الوسائل لرد المهاجرين ورفض استقبالهم، وهذه خطيئة جسيمة. فاليتيم والأرملة والغريب هم الفقراء بامتياز الذين يدافع الله عنهم دائما ويطلب منا أن ندافع عنهم. لا أحد يجب أن يكون في البحار والصحاري ليموت. لذلك علينا أن نوسع طرق الوصول الآمنة والمنتظمة لهم، ونسهل اللجوء للذين هربوا من الحروب والعنف والاضطهاد والكوارث المختلفة، ونعزز إدارة عالمية للهجرة بكل الطرق قائمة على أساس العدل والأخوة والتضامن. وعلينا أيضاً أن نوحد جهودنا لمواجهة الإتجار بالبشر ووقف التجار المجرمين الذين يستغلون بؤس الآخرين بلا رحمة. وأشاد قدسته بالتزام أناس كثيرين على مثال السامري الرحيم الذين يبذلون أنفسهم لمساعدة وإنقاذ المهاجرين الجرحى والمتروكين على الطرقات. والآن تحية البابا باللغة الإيطالية لأبناء الشرق الناطقين اللغة العربية.
Saluto i fedeli di lingua araba. Uniamo i cuori e le forze perché i mari e i deserti non siano cimiteri, ma spazi dove Dio possa aprire strade di libertà e di fraternità. Il Signore benedica tutti e vi protegga sempre da ogni male.
أحيي المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية. لنوحد.
I greet the Arabic speaking faithful. Let us unite hearts and forces so that the seas and deserts will not be graveyards, but spaces where God can open paths of freedom and fraternity. May the Lord bless you and protect you always from all evil.
Ojcze Święty, pielgrzymi z Polski i z innych krajów pragną przekazać Waszej Świątobliwości wyrazy synowskiego oddania i szczerej wierności, zapewniając o modlitwie we wszystkich intencjach Jego apostolskiej posługi. Oto streszczenie katechezy Ojca Świętego. Drodzy bracia i siostry, dzisiaj, odkładając zwykłą katechezę, chciałbym zatrzymać się z wami i pomyśleć o osobach, które również w tej chwili przemierzają morza i pustynie, szukając pokoju i bezpieczeństwa. Bracia i siostry, wszyscy możemy zgodzić się co do jednego. Na tych morzach i pustyniach nie powinno być dzisiaj migrantów, którzy często znajdują tam śmierć. I nie osiągniemy tego poprzez bardziej restrykcyjne prawo, militaryzację granic, ani poprzez zawracanie z drogi. Osiągniemy to natomiast poprzez poszerzenie bezpiecznych i legalnych dróg dostępu do migrantów, poprzez ułatwienie schronienia dla osób uciekających przed wojną, przemocą i prześladowaniami, a także poprzez połączenie sił w zwalczaniu handlu ludźmi i powstrzymywanie przestępców bezlitośnie wykorzystujących nędzę innych. Chciałbym wyrazić uznanie i pochwalić wysiłki wielu dobrych Samarytan, którzy starają się ratować i ocalić rannych i porzuconych migrantów. Ci, którzy nie mogą być jak oni na pierwszej linii frontu, mogą wnieść swój wkład poprzez modlitwę. Zjednoczmy nasze serca i siły, aby morza i pustynie nie były cmentarzami, lecz przestrzeniami, na których Bóg może otworzyć drogi wolności i braterstwa. Obecnie Ojciec Święty pozdrowi nas Polaków w języku włoskim.
Saluto cordialmente i pellegrini polacchi. Da qualche anno dimostrate un grande aiuto samaritano e una grande comprensione per i rifugiati di guerra provenienti da Ucraina. Continuate ad essere ospitali con loro che hanno perso tutto e vengono da voi contando sulla vostra misericordia e sul vostro aiuto fraterno. Vi sostenga in questo la Sacra Famiglia di Nazareth, che anch'essa in un momento di pericolo ha cercato rifugio in un paese straniero. Dio vi benedica.
Oto słowa Ojca Świętego. Pozdrawiam.
I cordially greet the Polish pilgrims. For the past few years, you have shown great Samaritan help and understanding for war refugees from Ukraine. Continue to be hospitable to those who have lost everything and come to you counting on your help and mercy. May the Holy Family of Nazareth and also in a time of danger, who also in a time of danger sought refuge in a foreign country. May they support you in this. God bless you. And finally, the Holy Father will now exchange greetings with the Italian-speaking pilgrims.
I fedeli di lingua italiana desiderano esprimerle filiale affetto e sincera fedeltà e pregano per tutte le intenzioni del suo universale ministero apostolico. A conclusione di questa udienza, canteremo la preghiera del Padre Nostro in latino, terminata la quale il Santo Padre impartirà la benedizione apostolica, che estende in modo speciale ai bambini, agli anziani e ai sofferenti. Benedirà anche i rosari e gli oggetti di devozione che ciascuno porta con sé.
I extend a cordial welcome to Italian-speaking pilgrims. In particular, I greet the participants of the summer meeting of seminarians. They are very loud, these seminarians. To them, I wish the best of continued formation, nourished by the Word of God and the Bread of Life. I also greet the parish groups, especially those of Marinella, Bagnara, Calabra, and Rovato. I welcome with joy the confirmation class from the Diocese of Chiavari. Dear brothers and sisters, with the gifts of the Holy Spirit which you have received in confirmation, your friendship with Jesus has become more intimate and is nourished by the Eucharist. This is why I encourage you to participate faithfully in Sunday Mass and also to approach the sacrament of penance and confession. It is the encounter with Jesus which forgives our sin and helps us to do good. We say Chrism is God's sacrament. Unfortunately, after that sacrament, we always say that they don't return to church after Chrism, the sacrament of Chrism, but I know you will always come back to church. Let us think about many countries that are at war. Palestine, Israel, and the martyred Ukraine. We think Myanmar and North Kivu and many, many other countries that are at war, that the Lord will give them the gift of peace. My thoughts finally go out to the young, the sick, the elderly, and the newlyweds, these who are here. In imitating St. Augustine, whose liturgical memorial we celebrate today, be thirsty for true wisdom and unceasingly seek the Lord, the living source of eternal love. To all of you, my blessings. The Holy Father, giving his thoughts and blessings at the end of this catechesis, and now we all recite the Our Father.
Sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos a malo.
Domino vobiscum. Sit nomen Domini benedictum. Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.
There we are. We have just received the apostolic blessing from the Holy Father, Pope Francis. It's a blessing that also extends to you, wherever you are, watching this broadcast, listening to this broadcast. Pope Francis today deciding to set aside the series of catechesis, the teachings that he has been giving, and speaking instead about the difficult and tragic human reality of modern migration, the suffering that goes with it, and the migratory routes that they take. He entitled his teaching today, Sea and Desert. My name is Father Paul Samasumo. Now we conclude today's live broadcast of the Pope's Weekly General Audience from St. Peter's Square on the 28th of August, 2024. If you can, do visit the Vatican News website, vaticanmedia.va. You will find news about today's general audience on our website on this portal. If you would like also to thank our partner television and radio broadcasters, Luminous Radio India, Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, Radio Maria England, Catholic Faith Network in America, Catholic TV, Shalom World Television, Salt and Light TV, Atmadashan TV, EWTN TV. On behalf of everyone here, thank you all. We now leave you with these images of the Pope greeting the various bishops and participants at this audience. Enjoy the rest of your day or evening, wherever you are. Laudetur Jesus Christus, praise be Jesus Christ.